and ground level perspective, please join me in welcoming our next speaker, the Chief Corporate Affairs Officer at Sterlite Technologies, Swati Rangachari.
So if you're okay, I'm just going to not stand beside the podium. You know, that's the problem when you're a little too short. Anyway, welcome everyone from lunch. I hope you've had enough fiber for lunch. Because right now we're going to be talking about the importance of network and the importance of fiber in the network. So fiber for 5G and how important at this point in time that is. Gopal, Balesh, Madam Aruna, they all mentioned about the importance of strengthening our networks because our networks is going to bring in a lot of socioeconomic good. Why so? Consumption levels are very high. India is currently at about 9.8 GB, but will be very soon leapfrogging to about an easy 18 GB per smartphone. So, you know, if you look at the consumption itself, we are having a high number of internet users, larger number of devices, more applications, and very soon, the Indian data consumer is going to perhaps be one of the highest in the world. Why so? Let's look towards the top right. If you're looking at networks and you're looking at the applications, today's applications and tomorrow's applications very soon will need networks that is very low on latency, high on bandwidth, and therefore when we're looking at 5G, perhaps the era is already here. Networks are required for it. More data means more fiber. Fiber for 5G. Thanks, Shyam. Shyam was the one who actually told me about the importance of 5G, and I really appreciate it. More data, more fiber. And with more data, changing business models. Conventional TSPs are moving into becoming DSPs. We have the OTT players who are ready to invest in networks. We have utility companies like gas and power who are looking at putting on fiber because fiber will give them the right kind of data. And then we also have governments who are rolling out networks today. Why so? We need to fiberize towers if you're looking at 5G coming into play. We are looking at newer forms of networks like the software-defined networks. We're looking at FTTX. Data centers are coming into play. Net-net, the network is becoming so critical today, and the fiber in the network is actually coming, you know, it's bringing in center stage of sorts. I know everyone speaks about spectrum, but let's not forget that when it comes to data and large bandwidth of data, you need the fiber. Countries across the world are investing pretty significantly in fiber. You take China, you take US, and even India, for that matter, will be investing pretty significantly as far as fiber is concerned. Historically, these are the six countries that are investing in fiber, and from what we see, there are about 100 countries already that are actually asking and buying the fiber from India. Indian fiber, incidentally, is very well known now in the world. And why am I saying that? The fiber industry is exporting into 100 countries. And you have national broadband plans coming up in several countries. Everybody is asking for fiber. They're getting themselves prepared for the next generation. Nothing like what's going to happen when 5G comes into play, right? So there is definitely, and I'm constantly talking about fiber because I'm giving you various aspects of why fiber becomes important. Just the way the networks are shaping up, right? So enhanced mobile broadband, we're talking about ultra reliable, low latencies. India might not have that, but we can well do with surgery that requires the kind of networks of the future. So why is fiber important for 5G? Just in, you know, in about, in the today's environment of an LTE coverage, just within about 500 plus meters, you don't see much of a cell coverage. But when it comes to 5G, very soon, within 100 meters, we're looking at small cells. We need more fiber for that. Fiber will constitute about 15-odd percent of the backhaul costs. And in the access points, we will need a lot of fiber with the coming of IoT and what have you. And more importantly, and this is something specifically for the Indian environment where sharing is allowed, it's not a very good idea to bring the fiber to the specific access points and try to split it at that point in time, because there will be a loss of data. And therefore, it makes sense to actually, when you're deploying, deploy with high count fiber. The quality of your data, therefore, will be much better. Deployment cost of fiber is very high. However, if you put high count fiber in the beginning itself, it will bear you well in the years to come. Fiber life in India is not very high, but across the world is pretty significant. So if we have the right deployment standards of fiber, we will have a lifetime of an easy 20 years plus. Everyone spoke about investments, spoke about financial crisis. This is an area I'd like to highlight upon. Honestly, when we talk about the highways of India, which is fiber, I think it's important to take a chapter out of what's happened with the road and highways. So the road and highways came up with a different way of investment. First of all, considering that they are an essential infrastructure, they ensured that the government ensured that there is a central road fund, where there is investment from the union budget, there is, cess and tax of the fuel consumption was put into that, custom duties was, reinvested into the fund. And why don't we do the same thing when it comes to telecom infrastructure, especially when it comes to fiber? Honestly, why should the, service providers need to put in that much of CapEx investment when the government can actually come out with a fund like this and perhaps, lend it out in terms of, loans, several years, low percentage of loans, for example. So the private sector should be able to avail such a fund similar to that of the highways. Look at point three, Bharatmala. We do have a BharatNet, yes, I agree, but we should move from BharatNet to fiberization of the entire country, and a large amount of the investments must come from the government. So my point of view is that, it's really important at this point in time that the government looks at three, four areas as enablers. One is, of course, bring a high level of focus on the rollout of fiber, and that's not really about just the ROW, which is ease of business, but it's also to do with the procurement standards of fiber, the deployment standards of fiber, and the maintenance of fiber for 5G. The other aspect is, maybe from a licensing perspective or otherwise, really open up the market for other players to come in to roll out networks. On these two counts, and finally the third one is, it's really important that this ministry is actually viewed more as an investment ministry where, the government should really look at bringing in more funds into the ministry versus leaving it totally in the hands of the private sector. So that's it from my end. Thank you.